My name is Aren Serik. I work at Alstom in charge of the development of the modernization solutions. And I'm really happy to present you today how we are giving a second life to our customer fleets. And to start with, I would like to propose you a few numbers and ask you what do you think is the common point between these three numbers? We are talking here about seats, about carpet, about actually a lot of plastic bottles. Any idea of the common point between these three things, these three numbers? Any clue? So the answer is the following. All these figures are related to the modernization of a fleet. But a modernization that Alstom has performed together with an operator recently, and you will see in a few minutes which operator we are talking about. It's a modernization that we have performed, bringing more technology, more innovation, but we have done it in a sustainable way. We have refurbished, we have recycled, we have used sustainable material. So what we call this at Alstom, bringing more technology, more innovation in a sustainable way on an existing fleet, this is smart modernization. And this is how we are intending at Alstom to bring a second life to our customer fleets. So to understand a little bit better what it is all about, let's look at two examples of smart modernization that we have performed recently. The first one is about Renfe in Spain. Renfe has a fleet of very high-speed trains, not so old. We are talking about 10-year-old fleet here. They had an issue. The issue is the following. The energy costs in the current context are very high recently in the last years, and it's a real issue for Renfe in terms of operating costs. On the other side, we have a second example. Avanti in the UK with the West Coast mainline fleet. Here we are speaking again about high-speed trains with a fleet which is a little bit older, 20 years. Here the issue is different. We have aging interiors. In some cases, the seats are worn out. In some other cases, passengers have difficulties to store their luggage. They have difficulties to charge their smartphones. So we have these two questions from Renfe and from Avanti, and we have discussed with them to find some solutions. How can I reduce my energy bill? How can I improve passenger experience? The answer is, again, around smart modernization. And this is how we have called the catalogue of solutions that we are bringing to the operators on existing fleets to answer to different needs. You have seen we are talking about energy, we have talked about passenger experience, but with existing solutions to improve the performance of an existing train. So this portfolio is quite comprehensive. As you've seen, we talked about energy, we've talked about interiors. It's made of several solutions. We are talking about operation performance, for instance, driver experience improvement, improve as well the signaling performance is one of the examples. Another chapter that we are addressing, as you have seen with Renfe, is the energy performance. We are able to upgrade the traction of the existing fleets. We are talking about in high-speed trains, but for sure we can do it on locomotives, on metro, on trams, and so on. We can action the HVAC solution, the lighting solution, and some others. We are also able to work on the passenger experience, as you have seen with Avanti. Many topics are feasible here in the interiors, but also about communication, connectivity, and so on. And to finish with, we have also a chapter to address the digital services when we want to improve the network upgrade, when we want to bring some cyber security enhancement. This is all about digital services. As you see here, we are talking about a lot of solutions, various solutions. What makes the common point between these solutions is that we are talking about more than 100 solutions which are already proven in use. We have already implemented them in some modernization examples, but also in new built examples. We are taking the same solutions for new built and for services or modernization. This makes the return on experience even better and brings low risk approach to the customers. So really a comprehensive portfolio on existing fleets based on proven in use solutions. As you have seen, we have this example of Renfe that we mentioned. They have chosen to go for energy performance. We have seen as well Avanti. They have chosen to go for passenger experience. Obviously, this is a choice that can be made together between Alstom and the operators in order to choose the best fit solution depending on the needs of the customer, on the status of the fleet, also on the age of the fleet. And the age of the fleet is an important criteria. As you know, we are often talking about a lifetime of a fleet, which is around 30 years, sometimes more. And we often know the specific milestone, which we call the midlife overhaul, when we target to continue the existing performance of the fleets. But why only focus on keeping the existing performance when we can also bring some new technologies, when we can bring innovation, when we can bring some energy reduction aspects? So this is all about smart, as you have understood, and smart can happen not only at midlife overhaul. It can happen together with the midlife overhaul, but it can also happen at any time of the train fleet lifetime. Renfe has done it at a given context, in a given context of high energy prices, and it's around 10 years of lifetime for the fleet. Whereas on the other hand, Avanti has chosen to do it a little bit later, 20 years old fleet, and in this case, they have chosen the opportunity of a concession renewal to do this smart modernization exercise. As you see, again, adaptation to the fleet planning, to the fleet needs, to the age of the fleet, it's something above technology, above innovation, is the adaptation to the planning. If we look at the results that we have achieved with these two examples, the first one is the Renfe example. We are, if you remember, we have taken the energy performance chapter. We have not worked on the traction, not on the HVAC, not on the lighting. Here, what we have done together with Renfe is work on the driver advisory system. The target here is to choose at driver level the right speed in order to save energy. The result, I think, speaks for itself, 11%. 11%. Validated by Renfe, is the average reduction of consumption for the whole fleet. We are talking here about Madrid-Malaga, Madrid-Valencia lines. For the full fleet that we are talking about, 11% for the 20 or more remaining lifetime of the fleet. It's huge. It's a real asset for Renfe in terms of total cost of ownership with a quick return on investment. We are talking here about 2.5 years. Definitely, it's something which was a success for both the operator and Alstom, and that we want to conduct also on other opportunities. The second example that we've seen with Avanti, here we are talking about passenger experience. As you've seen, you've got the before status on the left, you've got the after status on the right. We have here brought a new life, literally, to the trains by refurbishing the seats, bringing new tables able to charge intelligently the smartphones wireless. We have brought some seat reservation systems. We have brought also a new redesigned cafe. So passengers entering the train, the reaction was sometimes we are entering a new train, but we are talking here about an existing fleet which has been modernized in a smart modernization way. So definitely more technology, more innovation. But if you remember the first quiz, we were talking also about sustainability. We have done it also in a sustainable way. If you take the tables that we have seen on the Avanti use case, we have used recycled bottles to implement the tables. If you take the carpet, we have used sustainable wool. If you take the lighting, we have replaced with the LED lighting, which has enabled to reduce the energy consumption. The seats were refurbished, enabling also to have a circular economy approach. So definitely it's about technology, it's about innovation, but it's also about sustainability. Now, I think you might be ready for the second quiz now. I hope so. We'll stay on the example of Avanti. Avanti, you can imagine, it's an operator with a huge fleet. They cannot afford to stop the overall operation. They need to do it progressively. What the choice which was made together with Alstom is to refurbish one train at a time. All the fleet is running in operation, and we refurbish one train. How long would you say we need to refurbish one of these trains? And we are talking about high-speed train. Remember, we have changed the seats. We have put in place new seat reservation systems, LED lighting, many other things. Is it 2 weeks, 1 month, or 3 months? Any guess? 2 weeks? You've got the right answer. It's 2 weeks. To be more precise, it's even 10 working days. So you can imagine the operator is getting back one train in operation every 2 weeks. So it's a huge asset again here in terms of operation and ability for the operator to continue the operation without an important perturbation for the operation. So to summarize our offering here with smart modernization, what's fascinating, it's about many advantages that we can bring with low risk. What we are insisting on is that we have proven solutions which have already been put in service on new trains and also on modernized trains. So we have a short implementation time, as you have seen. We are focusing on return on investment. We are focusing on technology, doing it in a smart, in a sustainable way. So it's something that we can work together with the operators to put it in place, as we have done it with Renfe and Avanti. The way forward is quite simple. We are not taking years to do that. It's important to go fast and to decide fast. We start by together with the operator a return on investment analysis. It's important to choose the right solutions. If the solution has a return on investment which is more than 10 or 15 years, we just don't propose it, we just don't do it. We take the shortest ones. We do it through a short pre-study. We are talking here about weeks, we are not talking about months. We select the best fit solutions, and we can as well do a proof of concept on an existing vehicle or an existing train before doing the rollout. So it's all about having a common approach between the operator and Alstom, do it in a fast way and with a positive return on investment. To conclude, I would like to give the floor to Confucius. Confucius, as you know, is a Chinese philosopher. He was living in the 5th century before Christ. His philosophy was a lot about kindness. So really, I think I would have loved to have some philosophical chat with him. But here he's telling us that basically in this sentence that we only have one life. So I would tend to disagree with Confucius, with all due respect to him, because I think that speaking about our trains, they have a second life. They don't only have one life. We think at Alstom that the trains have a second chance. And you know what? Their second life is even better than their first one. Thank you for your attention.
Hello.
Hello.
Just a quick question. Do you proactively offer your customers such a second life, or do you wait for them to come to you, or do you use any AI or any white space analysis to offer them this smart modernization?
Thank you for your question. It's an important one, because what we see with our customers is that often it doesn't come through the offers or the tenders that we have. And usually we have often tenders around what we call the midlife overhaul, keeping the existing performance, extending the life, but keeping the existing performance. So definitely what we are doing, and we are doing it now as well, it's do it proactively more than through tenders. And this is through showing with this type of quick analysis, return on investment analysis that we can do in a few days, what is the best fit solution. We propose it to our customers. If they think that it's a good idea, what they can do is also mix it with an overhaul or maintenance activity to do it more efficiently. But yes, you're right. It's more a proactive approach. Yeah. Thank you.